एनी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द लास्ट क्लास?
सर
हाँ जी
सर, आपने एक हिल बताई थी कि सर उस हिल के ऊपर जो नवाब था वो रुका हुआ था और उसके एक
टीला
साइड
टाइप का, दैट वाज नॉट अ ह्यूज हिल और समथिंग, एक छोटा सा हम्प या माउंट कह सकते हैं।
ठीक सर।
नाउ द टॉपिक इज सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ बैटल ऑफ प्लासी, सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ बैटल ऑफ प्लासी, ये सुनो। नाउ व्हाट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ बैटल ऑफ प्लासी? एक्चुअली टू फाइंड आउट द सिग्निफिकेंस वी शुड थिंक और टेक द सिग्निफिकेंस इन थ्री टर्म्स और थ्री लाइन। फर्स्ट इज पॉलिटिकल सिग्निफिकेंस। व्हाट वॉज द पॉलिटिकल सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ बैटल ऑफ प्लासी? सेकेंड इज द मिलिट्री सिग्निफिकेंस, दैट व्हाट वॉज द मिलिट्री सिग्निफिकेंस of this battle, and the third was the economic significance. Third was the economic significance. Therefore, we are going to take all these significances one by one. Now, what was Battle of Plassey? What was Battle of Plassey? What was Battle of Plassey? It was fought between whom? It was fought between Nawab of Bengal and the British Company. This was the thing. Nawab of Bengal was Shiraz Ud Dawla. And the British Company was Robert Clive. Here, Shiraz ud-Dawla was killed and Robert Clive was won, and Mir Jafar was made the new Nawab of Bengal. Mir Jafar was made new Nawab of Bengal. About 500 men of Shiraz ud-Dawla lost their life, and about 85 men of Robert Clive died. Understand? Therefore, if you would say that this battle was militarily very high value, then you can't say it had any significance militarily. Politically, one Nawab was killed and other Nawab was established, and this new Nawab, that is Mir Jafar, was sovereign in itself? Yes or no? This new Nawab was sovereign in itself. This new Nawab was not taking anything, or this new Nawab was not under the subjugation of Britishers. Yes, there was no doubt that company helped the Nawab to get the throne. Company helped the Nawab to get the throne. Therefore, what happened? When company helped the Nawab to get the throne, it means when company helped the Nawab to get the throne, therefore company got a political influence. It means political power of company increased. Understand? When company got the influence, that is political power of the company got increased, after that, this power was converted into political dominance by the company in due process of time. In due process of time. No, don't write it down. I will dictate it, dictate the every line. Don't worry about it. Just concentrate what I am telling you. Yes or no? Yes or no? Therefore, write about political significance. Political significance of this battle. Political significance of Battle of Plassey. Political significance of Battle of Plassey. What was the political significance? Answer is nothing much. Nothing much, बहुत ज्यादा नहीं. Nothing much, mainly in immediate sense. In immediate sense, the Battle of Plassey did not had nothing or so much significant, because one Nawab was replaced by other Nawab. One Nawab was replaced by other Nawab. One Nawab was replaced by other Nawab. Understand? And new Nawab, whoever was the new Nawab, who was the new Nawab? Mir Jafar. And new Nawab, and this new Nawab was independent and sovereign authority. Independent and sovereign in authority. Simple. This new Nawab was independent and sovereign in authority. Understand? Now, since the company helped the Nawab, to get the throne. Company helped the Nawab to get the throne. When company helped the Nawab to get the throne, therefore, political influence of company increased. Political इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द कंपनी इंक्रीज्ड, पॉलिटिकल इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द कंपनी इंक्रीज्ड, एंड व्हेन दिस पॉलिटिकल इन्फ्लुएंस इंक्रीज्ड, व्हेन दिस पॉलिटिकल इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द कंपनी इंक्रीज्ड, अंडरस्टैंड, लेटर पीरियड इन द कमिंग पीरियड In the coming period, this influence was converted into political dominance. This political influence was converted into political dominance. Yes or no? Write down about it. The political significance of Battle of Plassey The political significance of Battle of Plassey was nothing much in immediate sense. Because The Nawab of Bengal was still an independent and sovereign authority. Full stop. Since company helped the Nawab to get the throne, political influence of the company increased. It was only during coming years that the company converted this political influence into political dominance. Political dominance. अंडरस्टैंड, फुल स्टॉप. पॉलिटिकल डोमिनेंस कॉमा कॉमा एंड द नवाब लॉस्ट हिज पावर टू इंग्लिश कंपनी एंड द नवाब लॉस्ट हिज पावर टू इंग्लिश कंपनी. नेक्स्ट हेडिंग मिलिट्री सिग्निफिकेंस. मिलिट्री सिग्निफिकेंस मिलिट्री सिग्निफिकेंस. नाउ द मिलिट्री सिग्निफिकेंस इज मिलिट्री सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ बैटल ऑफ प्लासी वॉज नेग्लिजिबल. Why it was negligible? Because planning military might no training supi training no arms superiority no planning military might training arms superiority nothing in any way all these things were not tested. These things were not tested. Yes or no? If these things were not tested, yes or no? The results came out. Results came out by trickery and conspiracy. Yes or no? Real power was not tested. Real military strength of both powers was not tested in this pattern. Therefore, it did not give any military significance to the company. Understand? Yes or no? Military significance not tested through military significance of the company. Yes or no? Write down next. Economic significance. Economic significance. Economic significance. This is the most important part. Actually, the only objective of the company was the economic. They never wanted to establish their political dominance or the military dominance. They just wanted to secure दे जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू सिक्योर मिलिट्री सॉरी सिक्योर देयर इकोनॉमिक इंटरेस्ट, यस और नो? दे जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू सिक्योर देयर इकोनॉमिक इंटरेस्ट. इकोनॉमिक सिग्निफिकेंस वॉज ग्रेट. इकोनॉमिक सिग्निफिकेंस वॉज ग्रेट बिकॉज बैटल ऑफ प्लासी, बैटल ऑफ प्लासी डिड व्हाट? इंक्रीज्ड द पॉलिटिकल इंफ्लुएंस ऑफ कंपनी इट इंक्रीज्ड द पॉलिटिकल इंफ्लुएंस ऑफ कंपनी एंड दिस पॉलिटिकल इंफ्लुएंस वॉज यूज्ड बाय कंपनी टू एस्टेब्लिश इट्स कमर्शियल मोनोपोली इन बंगाल. यूज्ड बाय कंपनी टू एस्टेब्लिश इट्स कमर्शियल मोनोपोली इन बंगाल. Establish its commercial monopoly in Bengal Understand how one first thing gifts to company officers, second trade concessions to company, private gifts to Robert Clive, it was also huge, private gifts of Robert Clive, these were also huge. Yes or no? Understand? And these benefits, and only company got 1 crore silver coins in cash from Nawab, and this much amount was used by company to finance Carnatic Wars, yes or no? And actually they have cash now, they had cash now. Yes. And there are two things. One is a battle, another is a war. Yes. One is what? Battle. Another is war. Battle is generally, the results of battles are generally dependent on might on the military might, on the strength of arms, on the planning, on tactics, on training. But battle, war is a process. Long drawn means which is fight, which is fought for a number of years, 6 years, 7 years, 2 years, 10 years, and a lot of battles are fought for it. A number of battles are generally fought for it, and that is not limited to a single day or single territory or single region. When you see Panipat, Battle of Panipat means that war, that battle was fought just for a single day. Battle of Panipat was fought just for a single day. Yes or no? Battle of Panipat was fought just for a single day. Yes or no? Second thing, but on the other hand, Carnatic War. If you would see Carnatic War, first war continued from 1746 to 1748. 2 years continuously, and a lot of battles were fought for it. This was a war. Second was 1749 to 1754. It was a war. Why it was a war? Why it was a war? Yes or no? Why it was a war? It was a war because it was fought for 6 years. For 5 years. Then 1756 to 1763, they fought for 7 years continuously. It means more than 100 small and large battles were fought here. More than 100. Yes or no? If you have to fight more than 100 battles, you always want what? Resources. What do you want? Resources. From where you get resources? From where you would get resources? Yes or no? From where? Bengal. Company got 1 crore of rupees. Company got 1 crore of rupees. Write down. The economic significance, of this battle was great because the company used its new found political influence to establish commercial monopoly in Bengal. Full stop. Next para. Bengal emerged as Bengal emerged एज प्लंडर्ड स्टेट एज वेल एज प्लंडर्ड स्टेट एज वेल एज स्पॉन्सर्ड स्टेट। This is a question. Possible question, write down. I'm not making you write answer here. Just it is a statement. I will explain the answer sometime later, but before it, just focus. The Bengal emerged as plundered as well as sponsored state. Plundered as well as sponsored state because the company exploited the resources of Bengal in every possible way. In every possible way. In every possible way. Next para. The resources gained by company from Bengal, the resources gained by company from Bengal comma as a result of its victory in the Battle of Plassey as a result of its victory in the Battle of Plassey comma proved to be decisive proved to be decisive in Anglo-French rivalry next para the company received 1 crore rupee company received 1 crore rupee under bracket silver coin from Mir Jafar and zamindari of Twenty-four Pargana from Pargana for placing him on the throne of Bengal. For placing him on the throne of Bengal. Full stop. This resource was used by company टू फाइनेंस कार्नाटिक वॉर्स। कार्नाटिक वॉर्स फुल स्टॉप। नेक्स्ट, इट वॉज द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ दीज कंपनी दीज रिसोर्सेज। नेक्स्ट पैरा से, फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट पैरा, इट वॉज द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ दीज कंपनी दीज रिसोर्सेज। स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ दीज रिसोर्सेज gained by company from Bengal, gained by company from Bengal that enabled from Bengal that enabled It was the strength, I'm repeating, it was the strength of these resources gained by company from Bengal that enabled the English company to defeat the French forces in the Battle of Vandivash in 1760. In the Battle of Vandivash in 1760. In 1760. Understand? This is the significance of Battle of Plassey. अच्छा, आपको nature of Battle of Plassey लिखवाया था मैंने, heading nature of Battle of Plassey. Nature of Battle of Plassey. In this way you are going to learn about how to write answers. Actually one main thing is ये जो Battle of ये जो part है ये आपका सिर्फ और सिर्फ अभी करवा रहे हैं, ठीक है, और ये सॉरी मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री का मेजर पोर्शन अभी करवा देंगे, फिर वी वुड फोकस ऑन पीटी, वी वुड फोकस ऑन पीटी, पीटी के बाद जो बचेगा वो सारा मेंस में दोबारा से हो जाएगा। अंडरस्टैंड, 8th ऑफ फेब को हम नया पीटी का बैच लॉन्च कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि आपका मेजर पोर्शन बचा नहीं है, जो भी है वो साइड 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 बाय साइड चलता रहेगा, दैट इज आर हेडेक, वी विल टेक केयर ऑफ दैट। Okay, understand? Now, nature of Battle of Plassey. There are three words about. This is a question I am going to discuss about it. Nature of Battle of Plassey. Nature of Battle of Plassey. More of a betrayal, more of a betrayal than a real battle, than a real battle. Understand? It is a statement. It is a statement, and not only a statement, it is also a possible question about Battle of Plassey. Second statement, which is related to the nature of Battle of Plassey, is It was actually a transaction, and we are going to discuss these questions here. It was which actually a transaction, actually a transaction in which Nawab was sold out to Robert Clive. Question. It was actually a transaction in which Nawab was sold out to Robert Clive. Nawab was sold out to Robert Clive. Understand? Write down nature of Battle of Plassey. Likhenge, Battle of Plassey was more of a betrayal than real battle, because formally, only a small part of Nawab's troops fought honestly. Full stop. Next para. Nawab's forces were about 60,000. And only twelve thousand soldiers led by Mir Madan and Mohan Lal fought honestly in the battlefield of Plassey. Next para. The outcome of Battle of Plassey was not decided by strength of arms and quality of leadership. But by treachery. Next para. Traitors like Mir Jafar माणिक चंद, अमीन चंद, राय दुर्लभ, एंड जगत सेठ, कॉन्स्पायर्ड विद क्लाइव कंस्पायर्ड विद क्लाइव अगेंस्ट नवाब उद्दौला फुल स्टॉप. दिस कॉन्स्पिरेसी decided the outcome of this battle. Decided the outcome of this battle. Next para. Much before the first bullet was fired, much before the first bullet was fired, the fate of battle was known to conspirators. Next para. In this battle, only about 500 men were lost on Nawab's side. Were lost on Nawab's side and just 65 on English side. Full stop. This number of casualties also indicate that it was not at all hard fought battle. It was not at all hard fought battle. Next, in a serious battle, number of casualties would be much higher. Therefore, it is commented that Battle of Plassey वॉज नॉट अ ग्रेट बैटल बट अ ग्रेट बेट्रायल. फुल स्टॉप. अब ये लाइन लिख लेंगे, इट वॉज एक्चुअली, ये कंक्लूडिंग लाइन होती है, इट वॉज एक्चुअली अ ट्रांजेक्शन इन विच नवाब वॉज सोल्ड आउट टू रॉबर्ट क्लाइव, इन विच नवाब वॉज sold out to Robert Clive. Understand? Now let us discuss about these questions. Understand? The topics of these questions are, first is great betrayal and not a great battle. Not a great battle but a great betrayal. Battle but a great betrayal. The key point for this type of question is the damage. Yes or no? The loss of life, the loss of lives, and comparison with a hard fought real battle. Yes or no? And it is also connected with the conspiracies it is also connected with the conspiracies. What type of conspiracies were conducted and what were the promises given to them and what were the benefits got by every participant of this battle. Every participant of this battle. This is called conspiracy. It means Mir Jafar was offered with Nawabship. Mir Qasim was offered with Commander-in-Chief. Rai Durlab, Amin Chand, Jagat Seth, all were offered with great benefits. Yes or no? Along with it, after the battle, you would also explain after the battle, Nawab was, Mir Jafar was made Nawab, Mir Qasim was made Commander-in-Chief, a lot of benefits to Rai Durlab and Amin Chand. And what the British company got? Yes or no? It means, first step, how the conspiracies were hatched. Kaise shadyantra racha gaya? Second, what were the offers to everyone? Third, how the Battle of Plassey took place? Yani, scenario of battlefield of Plassey. Fourth, killing of Nawab, how the Nawab was killed. And fifth, what everyone got. What everyone got. किसको क्या मिला? What everyone got. What everyone got. In this way, you can write the answer in these five steps, and the concluding line actually, when you write an answer, there are three parts of it. When you write an answer, very first part of it is introduction. Middle part, we used to call it body. And the last part is conclusion. Introduction, body, and conclusion. Introduction and conclusion decides about 30% of your marks. 30% of your marks belongs to this introduction and conclusion. Sometimes, giving no conclusion, no introduction to an answer is also an introduction. And sometimes giving no conclusion is also a conclusion. Therefore, giving no introduction is also an introduction. Giving no conclusion is also a conclusion sometimes, but not every time. It is generally decided by question to question, situation to situation, and on the basis of what, on the basis of the thing that what answer you are going to write. And it decides about the writing skills of a student. What writing skills do you have? In what way you are going to write your answer? And it gives the information about the crux of your knowledge. Crux of your knowledge means what basic knowledge you have is the introduction. Therefore, you should focus on introduction and conclusion, and it generally comes from the lines you used to read in your books. When you used to read your books, some statements, some punchlines, some introductory lines, or some type of facts or concepts which are generally written in your books, which you used to read, can be used as, or generally these are used as, introductory line or concluding line. Therefore, when you read a book, focus on the line, focus on the nature of the line also. That whether this line can be an introductory line or as an concluding line, or it is just an ordinary line. Understand? If you are able to do so, you can do anything. If you are able to do any, you can write any answer. Yes, I used to tell you one more thing, that what is answer writing? Answer writing is like making a sabji, vegetable in your kitchen. whatever you want to eat or whatever you want to cook, the ingredients and the amount of ingredients depends from dish to dish. Yes. Whether if you want to just prepare boiled rice or want to prepare some biryani or some any other dish related to rice or potato or tomato or whatever the vegetable dish you want to eat. The ingredients, spices, the salt, the ginger and other things, the amount of ingredients vary from one dish to other dish. Similarly, while writing your answer, you who would decide that what should be written more or what should be written less. If and about is a question that more facts are required to be written, then you have to write more and more facts in that answer. But there are some type of questions in which there is no need of, not at all, any need of any facts. It is going to be decided by you and only you that what facts or what things you are going to write. What facts you are going to write. Or you can say that there is no need to write any fact in that particular answer. Therefore, while deciding your answer, while practicing answer writing, you have to focus on answer. You have to focus on the question. And you have to make a plan. And if you start writing your answer, don't do one thing. Don't try to write an answer in just 5 minutes. If you want to write in this manner, you are just committing a blunder and you are going nowhere. Yes. If you are writing an answer in 5 minutes on very first day, then you are definitely going to do some blunder and you are going nowhere because it is useless. That answer would be worth nothing. Why? Listen. What teachers, your students used to do, whatever I have told you in the answer, in the class, they would listen it carefully. Whatever I have made you to write, they would note in their notebooks, and they just have that much limited knowledge. And they just want to frame only these lines in the answer, which ultimately leads to lack of knowledge, and outcome only depends on that particular limited line. Our only objective is to make you understand. Our only objective is to make you understand about a topic. But more and more knowledge is to be developed by you. You only and you yourself. Therefore, before writing an answer, at least read that topic from a particular book and at least 2 to 4 times. So that you must have a required knowledge about that particular answer or particular topic. Only then you should decide about the fact that whether you should write this thing or that thing. Understand? Therefore, what time are generally a student should take before initiating the answer writing process. Simple answer is, you just have to do one thing, just read the question properly, first thing, mark the keywords of question. Third, read the related topic properly. Related topic, gather the important facts and lines. Fifth, think about these lines. And then only think about introduction and conclusion. Introduction and conclusion. Yes. And then think about introduction and conclusion. And then try to write the answer in the last. Yes or no? Try to write answer in the last. Answer in the last. You are not going to write that answer in a particular point or in just one day or the two. You are going to write that answer, or this whole process would take whole day. Definitely, it would take whole day. Therefore, don't worry or don't take any panic if you are spending a whole day, because you are preparing a topic. Whole day means approximate all these steps would take 4 hours at least, because it is the beginning. Beginning must start with such a long period. Don't try to write answer in just 5 minutes or 10 minutes. No, you don't have any need to do so. You have to think and you have to practice the answer writing with these particular steps. If you are not going to do so, then you are practicing something which is useless, because it will become your habit to commit or make that silly mistakes or that same mistake consistently, and which ultimately would become a reason of your failure. First, prepare the topic properly. First, read, at least collect all the facts, all the concepts related to about it. First, try to find out or try to collect all the statements and important writings or important lines related to a particular topic. Try to find out the introduction and conclusion. And I am sure that initially in the first step or for the first time, you are not going to find the introduction and conclusion perfectly. But don't worry, it is a part of practice. Yes, it is the part of practice. And everybody have to do so. Understand? Everybody have to do so. Okay? This way you should follow while writing your answer. And it could take 4 to 5 years, maybe morning to evening. But in the last, that topic of yours would definitely बी प्रिपेयर्ड एंड वन मोर थिंग विच इज इम्पोर्टेंट डोंट ट्राई टू राइट मोर देन टू क्वेश्चन मोर देन वन क्वेश्चन ऑन अ सिंगल टॉपिक ट्राई टू फोकस ऑन प्रिपरेशन ऑफ दैट टॉपिक नॉट मैनी टॉपिक मैनी क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू दैट पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक बिकॉज दिस प्रैक्टिस इज जनरली डन बाय college goers or college students but the main problem with all these students they would face in while giving the exam that in UPSC the UPSC asks an extempo type of question in which you have to take decision in the very first single step understand or at that particular spot but If you practice a particular topic and you just practiced 10 questions, it means you just practiced all those mistakes in the one go, which you just did in first question. Therefore, write a question and just frame the other questions. Don't write all these questions. Just write at least one or maximum two questions and just frame the rest of the questions that on what line I have to twist this answer. You just have to decide it and you just have to make your mind. And if you get successful in doing so, I can assure you that you are definitely going to get good score in your main. But first practice the question. First try to find out the answer, not just start hit and try type of preparation. That I am very intelligent and I am writing this and what is the mistake in it? This is a mistake. This itself is a mistake. Understand? Therefore, if you are going to write any answer. Then first think about it properly. First prepare that topic properly and try to not to leave any stone untouched related to that topic. Any point untouched related to that topic. Understand? If anybody want to ask any question, then just ask.
Yes, sir, it was very informative, sir. It was very informative and motivating.
Thank you. Tomorrow we are going to discuss these questions related to Battle of Plassey.
Sir. Sir, question write करते time हमें कैसे पता चलेगा कि हम एक right पे हैं?
मैडम सब्जी बनाते हुए कैसे पता चलता है कि कितने मसाले डालने हैं?
चक्के देख लेते हैं
sir. Experience.
सर बट फर्स्ट टाइम तो मम्मी बता देती है कि कितने डालने हैं अभी यहाँ पे आप कैसे बताएंगे
यहाँ बड़ा भैया बैठा हुआ बताएगा टेंशन क्यों ले रही है
ओके
व्हाई आर यू टेकिंग टेंशन आई एम प्रेजेंट हियर डोंट वरी
टुडे इज माय फर्स्ट क्लास
हां
स्टूडेंट एंड आई हैव जॉइनड टुडे
Mr. Oves speaking. What? Let Oves speak. Yes. Ask, beta. What do you want to ask?
Sir, I just want to ask you that it was my first class as well as my first initial. I can say that initial stay of my journey, sir. I'm just doing the BA honors in economics in first year, sir. So, sir, I'm just worried about that. How I can cover? Where from I start? So, sir, it's my difficulty. I think.
If you would start with fear, you can't do anything.
Yes, of course, sir.
Nothing. There is nothing in it unless you are not going to get some right direction. Try to hit on right direction and try to find right. Don't worry that it would take place or not.
Okay, sir.
Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, listen, all the students, if anybody is feeling that they just want to talk to me in one way or the other, they are allowed to do so. Just switch off your mic. They can call in my office after maybe today I'm free, or tomorrow after 12:30 to 5. Yes, you can, anybody can call me.
Sir, where from we can get your contact, sir?
If anybody want to call me or want to have a contact, want to talk to me, then there is a number. And ask the ma'am to have my talks with you, or talk to me. Just call on this number.
Of course.
She would definitely let you speak to me.
Okay, sir. Okay. I'm writing down it.
And any other question?
Sir, I'm not focusing on this. 99999.
99 4 times 1. 9407.
4 times 1.
9911119407.
Okay, sir. I am a new student of this very class, sir. I have joined today. Before I speak, I have spoken with ma'am, which is your coordinator of your education.
Counselor, yes. Counselor, ma'am is there.
Sir.
Okay.
So, yes, sir. So, I want to know that you are continuing your classes. How much you have read, and when you have started, and where from I have start?
Listen. Actually, whatever you have left, don't worry about it, because we would provide you.
Okay, sir.
1 year, 2 year, or 3 years time. If somebody is in first year, then he can get 3 years. If somebody is in second year, then he can get 2 years or 1 year or whatever the duration you want. We allows you to enter in any of our batch to complete your syllabus or to revise the complete syllabus as many times as you want. This is the benefit of online classes. One more thing, we are also providing you the recorded lecture. In these recorded lectures, what you would get? In these recorded lectures, you can watch this lecture is also recorded, because you can see the signal of red dot REC on your screen. It means this lecture is recording. And you are going to get this lecture on your app, which you would download. And you can watch all my videos on that as many times as you want to see. Okay.
Okay, sir. Sir, I have another question. The syllabus which is in UPSC, you cover all that very syllabus.
Yes.
And one thing is there, that is optional. Is there a facility of providing the coaching?
At present, we are providing only history as an optional. History as an optional subject. Very soon, we are going to start with political science, international relations, PSIR, geography, sociology. But very soon. At present, we have only history optional.
Sir, what about public administration?
It is a planning, but we are not thinking about it, about this particular subject. But we can recommend you about a teacher that who can teach you online also.
Rest of the options, you provide coaching to all the papers which are compulsory for UPS.
It means from PT to GS mains till interview, we are providing everything.
What PT means, sir? I do not know.
Tier 1, preliminary
what
test.
What PT?
PT means preliminary test. Okay. PT means tier 1. It means it is objective type of question. It is going to take place. It is called level 1.
Okay, sir.
Yes. Providing.
I got it, sir.
Thank you. Any other
question? Thank you, sir. Thank you. No, no, sir. Okay, thank you.
For more information, if you just want to take more information or if you want to talk to me, then call on the number from where you received the call or from where you received the link, or call on this number if you want to talk to me. There is nothing, no problem in it. We just talk to everyone. Okay?
Sir, your name is?
Oh, yaar, you are taking my class and don't know even my name. Hari Mohan is my name. You can find me on Google also. Just type Hari Mohan on Google, a person of my face, you would find on screen, that is me, Hari Mohan.
Sir, aapko to Google bhi pehchanta hai naam se hi.
Arre, mujhe bahut koi pehchante hai bhai. People from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, a lot of people knows me.
Yes, sir.
This is the one.
I'm from Kashmir, sir.
Okay, of course,
we are listening you from Kashmir, sir.
Net chalu ho gaya wahan?
Ji, sir.
Net chalu ho gaya Kashmir mein?
Haan ji, sir, chal raha hai, but with the speed of the 2G.
Woh aisa sun rahe. Problem hai. I have more than 40 students, but they have only single complaint that, sir, we are not getting your videos, we are not able to reach you. Na, bahut sare students se, matlab, itna wo, matlab, jise kehte na, mere ko dukh lagta hai ki main unse baat nahi
karta. Ji, sir. So you can see the struggle of the Kashmiri people to participate in UPSC.
Yaar, actually, I would discuss this matter about Kashmir on some other day. Actually, Kashmir is nothing but is a transition region of, and it have become a battlefield.
Ji, sir.
Whatever the battlefield in this world, they used to see this type of transition.
Yes, of course.
Afghanistan, whether it is Syria, Iraq, whether it is Kashmir, whether it is Nagorno-Karabakh, whatever the region you would see.
So Istanbul.
People used to suffer.
Huh? Yes, sir.
Istanbul also.
People used to suffer. But
of course, sir. But the Kashmir is, I think, but the Kashmir is still suffering from a lot of problems. Not internet, but the problems. We can say the killings, whatever. But
actually,
I think I am... I have no brother, need to say.
Problem is, wherever you would see the merging of powers, you would see such type of things. I would discuss this tomorrow.
Oh, shit.
Tomorrow or some other day, I would definitely discuss about it. So, we will talk to you tomorrow. If there is any problem, you can call me. Okay?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you so much.